Hello students, in this video I am going to analyze one of the CAT 2020 RC sets of slot 1. This passage is related to the North Elephant Sea. A good analysis of the structure of the passage is required in order to solve the questions properly. So let's first analyze the structure of the passage and then we will analyze the questions. Let's see how the passage is organized. The first two paragraphs talk about the identification of dialects in this North Elephant Seal population in the late 1960s. The third and the fourth paragraph talk about the confirmation of the reliability of the dialects by scientists and scholars. The fifth paragraph talks about the disappearance of dialects and how it exactly took place. And the sixth one talks about the transformation of the nature of seals. Let's understand the structure in some detail now. The first paragraph tells us that this was the first time dialects were documented in a non-human mammal. How were the dialects identified? Based on the observation that the threat calls of males at some sites sounded different from those of males at other sites. So basically, based on this difference, dialects were identified. Dialects prevail because of this difference. The difference boils down to the dialects. That's the point here. Let's understand the second paragraph now. All the northern elephant seals that exist today are descendants of the small herd that survived on Isla Guadalupe, which means there was an original population, an original island from where all the northern elephant seals descended. As that tiny population grew, northern elephant seals started to recolonize former breeding locations. This means that with the expansion of the population, with the increase in the population, northern elephant seals, since they recolonized their former breeding locations, they started moving to new locations. And the third sentence tells us that in the recently colonized islands, Liebow found that the tempos of male vocal display showed stronger differences to the ones from Isla Guadalupe, the founder colony. So the difference was greater in the recently colonized islands. So what we can understand is there was a founder colony, and in all the new colonies found, the tempos of the male vocal displays were different from those of the founder colony. To check the reliability of these dialects over time, Liebow and other researchers went to Annonova Island, and this island had the slowest pulse rates in their calls. What they found, the pulse rate increased, and this was an important observation. Although it remained relatively slow compared to the other colonies, but it still increased. The fourth paragraph explains why the pulse rate was increasing. At the individual level, the pulse of the call stayed the same. A male would maintain his vocal signature throughout his lifetime, which means the pulse rate of an individual seal would remain constant. So if a change is to happen in the overall average, it will happen only because of immigration. And it is clearly indicated here, immigration could have been responsible for this increase. As in the early 70s, 43% of the males came from the southern islands. A very important point to note out here is this inference drawn by the scholars. The dialects were perhaps a result of isolation over time after the breeding sites had been recolonized. So we can finally connect the dots that isolation resulted in dialects, and the migration from the original population resulted in the increase of the pulse rates. Having understood this, it's not very difficult to understand this paragraph now. As the population continued to expand and islands kept on receiving immigrants from the original population, the calls in all locations would have eventually regressed to the average pulse rate of the founder colony. So what you need to understand out here is, if the calls regress to the average pulse rate of the founder colony, then the difference will cease to exist. And if the difference is minimal or ceases to exist, this will result in the disappearance of dialects. So now we can very clearly understand what resulted or what caused the disappearance of dialects. The last paragraph, as I told you, highlights the transformation in the nature of seals. The last portion brings this to light very clearly. Modern males exhibit more individual diversity, which was not the case earlier, and their calls are more complex. While 50 years ago the drumming pattern was quite simple and the dialects denoted just a change in tempo, Casey explained that calls recorded today have more complex structures, sometimes featuring doublets or triplets. So this was the kind of transformation that took place. So all done now. We are all set to analyze the questions. Let us analyze question number one. All of the following can be inferred from Bewes' study as described in the passage except. So we are supposed to find an inference that cannot be drawn from the study. In order to decide whether these inferences can be drawn or not, we need to relate it to the information given in the passage, as in the information given about the study. Just keep in mind that we have already done the mental mapping of the passage. The first statement says, male northern elephant seals might not have exhibited dialects had they not become nearly extinct in the 19th century. So here this statement expresses a probability. First of all, it doesn't say they would definitely not have existed. That's not the point. Probably they wouldn't have existed had this not happened, had they not become nearly extinct in the 19th century. So what we are supposed to figure out is, like, can we infer this as a possibility, as a probability, not as a surety or certainty? This point you need to keep in mind. Now, based on our mental mapping, let us sum up the information that we have with respect to this option. First of all, in the 19th century, the species became extinct. Then there came into existence a small herd. Then with the increase in the population of the small herd, recolonization took place. And as recolonization took place, the difference in this call tempo was identified. And as a result, dialects were identified. This is the flowchart. Have you understood this? So in a way, we can say that extinction of this species was the starting point. Otherwise, the small herd would not have come into existence. And had the small herd not come into existence, recolonization would have not taken place with the increase in population. And the difference in call tempo would never have been identified. And as such, dialects would never have prevailed. This is just a possibility. The option doesn't say this would have certainly happened in this manner only. But the possibility, yes, is there. The probability of this happening in this manner can definitely be inferred. Therefore, the first statement can be inferred. Let's read the option 2. The influx of new northern elephant seals into Anonivo Island would have soon made the call pulse rate of its male seals exceed that of those at Isla Guadalupe. To figure this out, you need to quickly recall some information that you got from the passage. Point number one that you need to recall: the male seals in the Anonivo Island showed the slowest pulse rates in their call. This is very important. Second, as the population continued to expand and islands kept on receiving immigrants from the original population. Islands kept on receiving immigrants from the original population, as in all islands kept receiving immigrants from the original population, including Anonivo Island. Yes, seals in Anonivo Island had the slowest pulse rates. And the seals that migrated from the founder colonies had faster pulse rates. According to the statement given in the option, both have got mixed. Now, as you know, since average lies between the highest and the lowest value of the given data, the average pulse rate of the seals in the Anonivo Island cannot exceed that of the average pulse rate of the male seals in the founder island, that is Isla Guadalupe. Therefore, this statement is false. The third option, changes in population and migration had no effect on the call pulse rate of individual male northern elephant seals. It's clearly given in the passage. At the individual level, the pulse rate of the call stayed the same. And a male would maintain his vocal signature throughout his lifetime. So this is not going to change from this. It can be very clearly inferred. Third option can therefore be inferred. Therefore, the option can be eliminated. Fourth option, the average call pulse rate of the male northern elephant seals at Anonivo Island increased from the early 1970s till the disappearance of dialects. To understand whether the fourth option can be inferred or not, this piece of information will come in handy. As the population continued to expand and the islands kept on receiving immigrants from the original population. So, first thing that we already know is Anonivo Island was the one where the pulse rate of the seal population was the slowest. So, upon immigration from the original colony or the founder colony, the pulse rate would have gone up. This further very clearly explains that the pulse rate eventually regressed to the average pulse rate of the founder colony, and this is how the dialects disappeared. From this, we can clearly infer that this colony, which had the slowest pulse rate upon receiving immigrants from the founder colony, the pulse rates kept on increasing till the average pulse rate finally regressed to the pulse rate of the founder colony. And therefore, we can say that the call pulse rates at the Ananova Islands would have increased from early 70s till the disappearance of diamonds, as I have explained to you. Question number 2. Which one of the following conditions, if true, could have ensured that male northern elephant seal dialects did not disappear? This question is based on critical reasoning. You already have a complete understanding of the passage in your mind, right? Now just recall, why do the dialects exist according to the passage? Because the average call tempo of the seals in the recolonized islands were much different from the average call tempo of the seals in the founder island, right? For the dialects to be preserved, this difference has to exist. The option which, if true, tells us that this difference will be preserved would be the correct option. Let us figure out. Let's read option 1. Besides Isle of Guadeloupe, there was one more surviving colony with the same average male call tempo from which no migration took place. So this statement tells us that the migration did not take place from this one more surviving colony, but the migration would still be taking place from Isle of Guadeloupe. Therefore, the dialects would disappear. Option 1 therefore can be eliminated. Option 2, besides Isle of Guadeloupe, there was one more founder colony with the same average male call tempo from which male seals migrated to various other colonies. This option says that is there is one more colony like Isle of Guadeloupe with the same average. If this were the case, then dialects would disappear more quickly as migration would happen from two localities instead of one. This can also be eliminated therefore. Option 3. The call tempo of individual migrant male seals changed to match the average tempo of resident male seals in the host colony. If the call tempo of the immigrant male seals changed to match the average tempo of the male seals in the host colony, the original average of the call tempo in the host colony would remain unchanged. Therefore, the average call tempo of the host colony would still be different from that of the founder colony, and the dialects would remain intact. This is the correct option. Let's take a look at the fourth option. The call tempo of individual male seals in host colonies changed to match the average call tempo of immigrant male seals. Then the average call tempo of the host colony would match the average tempo of the founder colony. As a result, dialects would disappear. Therefore, this cannot be the option. Let's analyze question number 3. Which one of the following best sums up the overall history of transformation of male northern elephant seal calls? We have the overall mental mapping of the passage in our mind. The answer to this question is there in the last paragraph of the passage. Let's read option 1 now. Owing to migrations in the aftermath of near species extinction, the average call pulse rates in the recolonized breeding locations exhibited a gradual increase until they matched the tempo at the founding colony. This exactly sums up the disappearance of dialects, yes or no? And therefore this can be eliminated because the question is about the history of transformation. What sums up the history of transformation? Let's read the second option now. Owing to migrations in the aftermath of near species extinction, the calls have transformed from exhibiting complex composition, less individual variety, and great regional variety to simple composition, less individual variety, and great regional variety. Now it says less individual variety. Let's figure out whether it should be less individual variety or greater individual variety. Look at this portion. Modern males exhibit more individual diversity now. So the individual diversity has increased and the calls have also become more complex. So less individual variety here is wrong. So is the case with option 4 also. The calls have transformed from exhibiting simple composition, great individual variety, and less regional variety to complex composition, less individual variety. So again, less individual variety is wrong because once the transformation happened, they started showing greater individual variety. So both 2 and 4 can be quickly eliminated on this basis. 1 we have already eliminated, so 3 is the correct option, which very clearly shows great individual variety, and other things also are also right. Correct option therefore is 3rd. This was an easy question to solve. Let us analyze question number 4. From the passage, it can be inferred that call pulse rate of male northern elephant seals in the southern rookeries was faster because. Let's go back to the passage where the related detail is given. Let's read this portion. As in the early 1970s, 43% of the males on Ananevo Island had come from southern rookeries that had a faster pulse rate. So what is given in the passage? Southern rookeries had a faster pulse rate. Why southern rookeries had a faster pulse rate? This is not directly given in this paragraph, but can be figured out. Let's see how. Let's now carefully read this portion. The first settlers of Ananuvo Island could have had by chance calls with low pulse rate. At other sites where the scientists found faster pulse rates, the opposite would have happened. Seals with faster rates would have happened to arrive first. This particular sentence is important for us. At other sites where the scientists found faster pulse rates, which is that site? Southern rookery. Southern rookeries had faster pulse rate. So here the opposite would have happened, as in the seals with faster rates would have happened to arrive there first. Based on what we have understood from the passage, let us analyze the options. Option number one, a large number of male northern elephant seals migrated from southern rookeries to Ananuvo Island in the early 70s. The information regarding migration of the seals from southern rookeries does not tell us why the pulse rate was faster. It's unrelated information, therefore can be eliminated. Option number two, a large number of male northern elephant seals from Ananuvo Island might have migrated to the southern rookeries to recolonize them. We know that the average pulse rate of seals in Ananuvo Island was the slowest. So migration from Ananuvo Island to southern rookeries would have made the pulse rate slower, not faster. Therefore, this can also be easily eliminated. Let us read the third one. The male northern elephant seals of Isla Guadalupe with faster call pulse rates might have been the original settlers of the southern rookeries. This exactly gels with what we just now understood from the passage. As indicated in the passage, that they might have been the first settlers, and this could have been the reason for the faster pulse rate. This can be inferred. Fourth option, the calls of male northern elephant seals in the southern rookeries have more sophisticated structures containing doublets and triplets. This is related to the information given in the last paragraph, is not in any way related to why they had faster pulse rates, and therefore it's out of scope. The correct option is the third one.